For 6 months in 2011, a criminal the press dubbed the butt slasher menaced Northern Virginia. The facts about the Virginia butt slasher were similar in every reported assault. While shopping, a woman would come across a man trying to pick up some clothes. Once they offered to help, they would bend over and feel a pinch on their backsides. Assuming the pain came from a poke from a hanger, they would look up to find the man gone, and upon further inspection, discover a gash on their behinds. After being caught in Peru more than a year later, Johnny Pimentel's actions remained without a confirmed motive. Yet authorities speculated his strange assaults, which earned him 7 years in prison, stemmed from a rare sexual disorder. In 2011, the unknown butt slasher was targeting women in Fairfax County, Virginia. Local citizens were warned to basically keep track of their behinds while shopping. Fairfax County Police spokesperson Lucy Caldwell urged women in the area to pay close attention to surroundings and to contact the police or mall security if they felt they were being followed. The police also recommended that women not to go shopping alone. On Valentine's Day 2011, 40-year-old Johnny Pimentel marked his first known victim in the Fair Oaks Mall in Fairfax County, Virginia. The 20-year-old was pregnant when Pimentel grazed her as he passed by, tearing her leggings. Pimentel blamed the mishap on his bag, claiming it snagged her clothes. After he was gone, the woman realized that there was blood on her hand. Closer inspection of her wound revealed a 3-inch slice, which authorities later determined was likely made by an X-Acto knife. The woman started freaking out and reported what happened to the police, but the incident wasn't publicly shared until more victims surfaced. Pimentel set up the same scenario for most of his victims. The butt slasher would knock clothes or other items onto the floor of a department store and pretend to clean up the mess. The women would then offer to help him pick things up, turn their backs to him, and then feel a sharp pain in their behinds, which they attributed to clothes hangers poking them. The superficial wounds went unnoticed until the victims saw the blood. The first victim was the only one to report a different pattern during the 6-month spree. Pimentel brushed past her and pierced her buttocks as she carried her purchases. She shouted at him as he walked away, thinking that he had only cut her leggings. This could indicate that Pimentel developed his pattern to avoid attention. During the course of the hearing, Pimentel expressed regret. He also appealed for forgiveness from his victims. He never provided a motive or any sort of reasoning for the 9 assaults committed over a 6-month period in 2011. His lawyers admitted that they had no idea what had spurred his actions either, referring to the situation only as bizarre and terrible. One person to offer a potential explanation was former FBI profiler Greg McCrary. He suspected that Pimentel suffered from a sexual disorder known as piquerism, saying, "The offender probably derives sexual gratification from slashing or pricking or piercing women in sexually significant areas of their body. He isn't just going up and indiscriminately slashing women in their face, back or arms, where someone could say he's just perpetually angry at women. He's targeting a sexually significant body area." Pimentel, a Peruvian native, fled to his home country in late 2011, after Virginia police released his name and image to the public. Due to extradition laws in Peru, the U.S. Marshals Service could not enter the country to track him down, so authorities had to sign and file an Interpol red notice. Authorities in Peru arrested Pimentel in January of 2012 near a mall in Lima, Peru. It took nearly a year to complete the paperwork to process the extradition, but in December of 2012, Pimentel was eventually returned to the U.S. for his hearing. The first victim was a pregnant 20-year-old woman shopping on Valentine's Day in Fair Oaks Mall. Every victim that followed was in their teens or early 20s, with some victims as young as 15 or 16 years old. Police suspected that the teenagers did not realize that what happened to them should have been reported to the authorities. The transgressions also occurred in retail shopping environments. The final official victim count was 9, but it has been reported that as many as 13 girls and women may have been targeted. As authorities pieced together Pimentel's actions, they found 2 periods of activity. He nicked 3 women at the Fair Oaks Mall in February of 2011, followed by a 4th on March 11, 2011. Pimentel was dormant for 2 months before a string of 5 more assaults occurred from May 16 through July 25. There were no theories about the gap in April, but it's likely that Pimentel stopped after July, because the police had issued a public alert. The first victim spoke with several news outlets after her assault and criticized the Fairfax police for not publicizing her experience sooner. The butt slasher accosted her on February 14, 2011, but police did not alert the public until late July of the same year. After the information was made public, two more women contacted the police with stories of a man who cut their buttocks with a sharp object after they stopped to help him pick up clothes. The police spokesperson Lucy Caldwell told news outlets that the offenses took place over several jurisdictions, leading each department to believe the perplexing transgressions were isolated incidents. The victims were able to provide a clear description of their assailant to the police. Using the description, officers scanned surveillance footage from the three malls where the butt slasher struck. In August of 2011, they released images of the suspect to television stations and handed out thousands of flyers to the public. In September of 2011, the Fairfax County Police received a tip from a citizen that led them to the identity of the butt slasher. 40-year-old Johnny Pimentel. On September 6, 2013, the butt slasher received a sentence of 20 years in prison after reaching a deal that allowed him to plead guilty to only two counts of malicious wounding and two of unlawful wounding. Police say there were nine total incidences over the six-month period of Pimentel terrorizing Fairfax County, Virginia in 2011, but five were dropped as part of the plea deal. After receiving the sentence, the judge dropped it to 7 years in prison and 5 years probation. In a statement made during his sentencing hearing, Pimentel said, "I'm very remorseful for all the things that are occurring, and I ask you to pardon me." A half dozen of Pimentel's family members and friends were in court to support him. While none of the victims suffered serious physical injuries, this man could have evolved into something much more sinister, who knows, maybe even a serial killer. It's a known fact that serial killers also start small, with petty crimes, and evolve into the monsters we know today. Thank God this guy is only the butt slasher.